They make like a woo sound a lot. We walked on top of some hills and got up really close to some of them right before they flew. And with the like taller grass and less trees, they have larger places to nest and more places to nest around.
And this is something that we're teaching our grandchildren at the same time. As they come out, they know the importance of it and they are living it themselves. And that's what's really a joy to see.
For my grandkids, for my kids, I want to pass on an appreciation of the prairie. Now, I've pretty much dedicated myself the last 30 years or so to trying to maintain the prairie in as high a condition as possible, which means managing grazing, but also trying to keep invasive species from invading.
Dr. Browning and I share our same passion of the Flint Hills. And so when I first got here, people told me about Dr. Browning and his interest in preserving his pastures and making sure that they're well taken care of and trees were controlled and any other noxious weeds that were here on the pastures he took care of. So why do we do GPGI? You know, why the interest in the Great Plains Grassland Initiative? We've recognized that we are losing the open prairies of the Great Plains by woody encroachment. And so we need to reverse that trend. So we're actually doing a little different approach, and we're looking at these open prairies that still have some pressure from outside tree sources and seed sources, that we want to target those areas and get those clear from both trees and seed, and then expand that area from there. And if we can expand that area, then hopefully we can open up those more open sceneries and landscapes and get rid of those trees that are certainly threatening the open prairies of the Great Plains.
The GPGI program has sparked a renewed effort from me to hold true to what I've been trying to do for the last 40 years. I've gotten kind of tired, and this has given me the initiative to go back out and do what needs to be done to keep things the way they are.
We've been working with Dr. Browning to implement a conservation plan to evaluate what trees he does have on his landscape and in his pastures, and take out those undesirable trees. You know, we want to remove those invasive trees, those trees that we've found have taken over the rest of the Flint Hills. And so within Dr. Browning's pastures, we're seeing some trees come in from the neighbor and some trees come in from some of the woody draws that he has on his pasture. And if we can reverse that trend and open that pasture back up and get those trees that are producing seed, and even those trees that are young and that will produce seed eventually, if we can get rid of those, then we can create a true tree-free and seed-free landscape.
I think conservation is important to us because we think it's the responsibility of humans to take care of the planet. We have a strong appreciation for the special beauty of this area, this part of the prairie, and want to see it pass from our hands in as good a better condition than it was as we received it. I think we're accomplishing that so far.
But the joy of living on the prairie has been the joy of my life since we moved here, and by having a perfect prairie, then we have the ability to have a perfect ecosystem.